Today, I would like to introduce to you an unusual movie. For a change, it will be a documentary. This is one of three kinds of movies. The documentary movie is supposed to reflect the reality. The director may not intervene in the reality, he or she just depicts what he sees. In documentary movies, there are no actors. We watch real people who are simply themselves. Documentary movies have played a significant role in the Polish cinema, especially since the Second World War. What is important, it has never become a means of propaganda in Poland. It has always been treated as something artistic and culturally important. It is a kind of a movie which allows us to witness history. The title of today's movie is 89 millimeters from Europe. Its director is Marcel Łoziński. It is one of the most important Polish documentary movies. It got nominated for the Oscars in 1994 in the category Best Short Documentary. It also received many important awards, among others in Sydney, San Francisco, Montreal, Leipzig and Marseille. What does the title mean? 89 millimeters is the difference between the width of rails in Europe and their width in the countries of former Soviet Union. In Polish, the abbreviation of Soviet Union is ZSRR, which means Związek Socjalistycznych Republik Radzieckich. In English, it is USSR, Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. The official dissolution of USSR took place on 26th of December 1991. As a result, the following countries were formed: Armenia, Azerbaijan, Belarus, Estonia, Georgia, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Lithuania, Latvia, Moldova, Russia, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Ukraine, and Uzbekistan. Anyways, to get back to the point, the action of the documentary is set on the railway station in Brześć, which nowadays is a city in Belarus. After World War I, it was in Poland, and in 1939 it was annexed to USSR. Among others, the following people were born in Brześć: a very famous Polish actress Nina Andrycz and Jerzy Lipman, a cinematographer. The director, drawing our attention to the titular 89 millimeters, shows a figurative boundary between two worlds and two cultures, East and West. There is no need to comment on the scenes by Marcel Łoziński. People on the station are waiting for the train wheels to be adjusted, and the laborers who are doing it are enough just to see. Between those two worlds, there is a child. What role does the child have? What role will the child have? You will see after you have seen this short and poetic movie. The most important person whom I would like to introduce to you is the director Marcel Łoziński. He was born in 1940 and graduated from the Department of Film and Television Direction at National Film School in Łódź. The university is the most important and the most well-known film school in Poland. Other important institutions which educate young filmmakers are Wajda School and Krzysztof Kieślowski Film School in Katowice. The last one used to be called the Department of Radio and Television at the University of Silesia, but today it is still part of the university, but following the reform of higher education in 2019, it has changed its name. Marcel Łoziński conducted workshops on documentary movies in Marseille, and he was the head of Doc Pro documentary program in Wajda School. The other important person is Jacek Petrycki, who was a director of photography, a cinematographer. Apart from that job, he also is a director and a scriptwriter. In 1976, he graduated from the same film school as Łoziński. His important movies are The Lonely Woman, directed by Agnieszka Holland, and Interrogation, directed by Ryszard Bugajski. Since 1987, he was a co-worker at BBC TV station and British Channel 4. In 2010, he was awarded a silver medal for merit to culture, which is called Gloria Artis. This medal is awarded by the Minister of Culture and National Heritage to the people and institutions who outstand in the field of cultural activity. There are three classes for this medal. First class, the gold medal. Second class, the silver medal. And third class, the bronze medal. You are surely wondering how it is possible that trains in Europe run on 1,435 mm rails, while in former USSR countries, in USSR, on 1,524 mm rails. How did it happen? As legend has it, the wider rails were Peter the Great's contribution, who claimed that if Russia had been the biggest country, it should have had the biggest rails gap. The real reason was probably the safety of the country. Up till now, this difference, this wide rails, still applies in Russia, Mongolia and Finland. Apart from trains, underground also runs on such rails. 89 millimeters from Europe lasts 12 minutes. I hope you will find the time spent on watching the movie well spent. Enjoy the movie and see you next time. See you in the next part of our meeting.